sun has come up. It's overcast, but it's not going to rain. This is the day. This is the hour. What's going to happen today? Today is November the 12th, 2004. This is the New Birth Pentecostal Church. This is going to be built this weekend. Say something.
A lot of fun. Y'all been here.
Go ahead, say something.
Here we are right now on this sort of working device. But we're with Brother Shipping, our mission director. Now, Brother Shipping, what was your contribution to this project?
Well, Church of the Day project is a home mission project from the General Home Mission Division at our headquarters. So this is the first of its kind in our district. So we got with Brother Phillips, had the dream, and now it's becoming a reality.
So it must be really nice for you seeing this dream come into fruition.
Right. It's been a long time dream of mine to see this happen.
And here it is.
That's right. And we'd like for more of these to happen across the district, the great state of Mississippi.
All right.
Church of the Day. This morning at 5:00 a.m. Religious Justice Lab. Now look at it. It's raining.
So what would you say about that?
I would say that is just wonderful. Just great. And by this time tomorrow, we will be here.
Hallelujah. Yes.
God's doing a good work here in Clinton. Are we?
Yeah.
Clinton, Mississippi.
That's right.
And he gave everyone tools and gifts. And if everyone works together with the tools and gifts God gave them, roofers not trying to be masons, and masons not trying to be roofers,
uh-huh.
What you're called to do.
Go ahead, brother.
It builds and it works and it functions. Amen.
All right. How about you, Brother Eddie? You want to give us a sermon tonight?
Man, we've been working all the time.
That's a message. It's coming up. It's 10 o'clock at night. And
actually, it's 9:30.
Is it really 9:30?
9:30.
Oh, see, we still got 30 minutes left. Okay, Jeffrey, give me my message for the day.
You know, I haven't done a building construction all my life, but I'm doing the work of God.
Go ahead, brother. Nothing like being able to work together. That's what it's all about. Firing.
Hold on. The gates of hell shall not prevail against the church.
Amen. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I gotta put this
up. Hi, I'm Mike from Great Britain, and I was passing by on the road, and I saw all this construction, and I was like, what's going on? It's like incredible. So I stopped here, and they're like building a church, and I was like, wow! And I looked everywhere. I can't see very well at times. I think it's because I'm getting older. But I was like, it's beautiful! And I learned that they're doing it in like, they're gonna finish in just a few 24 hours or so. So, and in my country, we just don't do stuff like that. So I was amazed.
Go ahead, say something.
Love. This is a fine work we got going on in Clinton. I just can't wait to see what God's going to do.
Amen.
Here we are live. live location at the building of this New Birth Church in Clinton. And it's, as you can see, an amazing project going on right now. And we've been looking for Brother Scott Phillips, and he just magically appeared behind me. So that's the will of God. It must be the will of God, because we're about to go up in there and search for New Birth. So we have the churches, New Birth, Pentecostal Church.
That's right.
But we've been doing those New Birth, New Bethel, New Birth Tabernacle.
Yeah, it's New Birth Pentecostal Church. It's powerful.
And that's right here.
We started exactly, give or take, an hour or two. About 37 hours ago. A lot of work is happening.
It's been
non-stop work.
It's just great, all these people coming together and working on this project. It really touched you.
I'm very thankful for people's generosity, their big heart, what the Lord's done.
All right, well, we'd like to look around the building if that's okay.
Oh, you just make yourself a home deck. Come on in.
I think this is exciting and wonderful, this particular day, to be able to rejoice what the Lord has done.
Amen.
And God has given a lot of people the initiative and the motive to come here and work for the Lord. And to me, that's exciting enough to know that it can be done. And I thank God for Brother Phillips and his motivation to be able to pull this together and see the corporation of the district to do a great work for the Lord.
It's about the Word of God. It's about the kingdom of God. It's about what the Lord's going to do in this last day. Praise God. I believe it's the Word of God to build churches everywhere. It's a sad day when there's 40 Baptist churches and only one Apostolic Church. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Praise God. We need to build churches everywhere. Praise God. Some preacher told me, well, you know you're lose people. I said, I lost them anyway. Praise God. I said, let me tell you something. You don't lose when you give to God's kingdom. There is no lose. There is no lose. Amen. I'm so thankful.
Just like this little tree. This will become a great tree, like the one beside it. We also believe that this little church is also going to be a great church. And me and my grandma! Yeah, let's go, grandma! We believe it's going to be great! And this is going to get huge! And everything's going to be like, yeah!
Hey, y'all. Say something.
Something.
That maybe you got a few more words.
I know that when I drove up yesterday and I saw what this man had done, I was amazed and overwhelmed how God's people just came together.
Isn't that great?
I was like, wow.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Doing good? I need to interview somebody. What's your name and where are you from?
My name is Kurt Benninghall. I'm from Jackson, Mississippi.
That's good.
Would y'all like to be Superman?
Yes.
Superman, come on. Come on now.
Says I am. I have what it says I have. I'll do what it says I'll do. Y'all, this is my Bible. It has given me new life because it is the Word of God. Can you hear me sing? This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I do what it says I do. This is my Bible. It has given me new life. It is the Word of God. Let me tell you about it now. When I'm lost, it helps me find my way. When
sitting on a piece of land in a building with people there. Who would have ever, I don't know how very many people would have gambled on that. Amen. It was 1 year ago, October, that we first moved to Clinton. And the reason why we moved to Clinton, because we were moving to the Jackson area for a season. And through the providence of God, God connected us and brought us together with Pastor Jerry Dillon. And he had a vision and a desire to have a church in Clinton. He knew Clinton needed a strong apostolic church that represented the power of God to this community. Brother Dillon had the desire, the permission, and all he needed, he just needed to find somebody to come. And I believe that every person, even the man that had the burden to come and then felt the burden lift, I believe, and I think of the things that God has done. I look at this electrical wire and I can say God is an electrician. God is a framer. God is a brick mason. God is a window. God is a front door. God's a back door, side door. God is an office. God is in the back. He's in the front. You know, what is the metaphor we would use? And I saw it. I saw it up in my eyes. I saw it all around me. I felt it. I shook hands with it. I hugged it. I talked to it. I ate with it. This weekend, I experienced one of God's greatest metaphors in the body of Christ.
Yes.
The Bible says we are His body, members in particular.
Yes.
And so I saw Jesus Christ. How did this building get built? The body of Christ came together at a certain time, at a certain place. The building, you're standing in the product of the work of God. It didn't just come by someone bending their knees and fasting and reading the book and praying for a miracle, but people sweated for a miracle. People worked hard into the night for a miracle. And every miracle that happens in our life, somebody paid a price. Somebody paid a price. Somebody did something. I saw Jesus as an electrician. I saw Jesus as a plumber. Even Jesus looks like big money. You know, he just kept on working. They just would never quit. Keep working. Sheet after sheet, nail after nail. People did things I couldn't do for myself. I can't even nail two by fours together. God, do for me personally, I know it's for all of us, but I have to view it personally because that's how He did it for me, what I could not do for myself. The bank would loan me money, and this church money, just because we're a new church and we don't have very many people. But I saw God and Brother Dillon when he went to the bank with this and signed the notes. And I saw God using people to help me do what I could not do by myself. And to me, the lesson for us all together is that God is whatever we need Him to be.
That's right.
If we need His father, He is our father. And if we need a friend, He is our friend.
Yeah.
If we need somebody to help us when we're broke down on the side of the road, He is that person that stops on the side of the road.
Right. Come on.
And it's not some angel, it's not some spirit. But God comes wrapped still today in the folds of flesh. We are the greatest revelation of Jesus Christ in the world. People wear crosses around their neck and say that's a symbol of Jesus. That's not a symbol of Jesus. You are Jesus Christ to this world.
Be a part of something that God is doing. Where people meet in the crossroads and lives are changed. be here if I listen to what people have said, things that I've been through, and to be a part of something of this magnitude. Nobody can get the credit but God.
Amen.
We're all instruments. We're all men from different walks of life. We're all people of different cultures. But to come together with one single goal in mind, to build a building in the name of the Lord of hosts. When souls will be saved, when people can come when they need healing, need salvation, or just need a prayer. That's what the New Birth Pentecostal Church is all about. And I'm so thankful of the people that I've met since Thursday. You know, Brother Phillips and I came out and just stood on this concrete slab and just a little rain pouring. And sometimes we just look around and say, is it going to happen? How can it happen?
Yeah.
With the help of the Lord, some strong backs, some late hours, and some determination from the men and women, not only this city, but our friends that have come far and near to make this place what it is. I wouldn't trade this for a billion dollars. I'm so happy, I'm so thankful to be a part of what's going on here in Clinton. Some great things are going to take place in the future. And I'm just excited about it. Amen.